I know, this is not one of my standard video entries, but last summer I traded fixing a woman's ring for this old shop press frame, and it's really a great frame, good and solid. So I pretty much sat around all summer. It's rusted as hell. We're going to drag it into the shop and adapt it to an old wood splitter that I got, oh, a couple of three or four years ago, that is just a pain in the ass to use. I mean, you know, it will run, but it takes forever to get it running. So we're going to strip this baby out and take all the hydraulics out of it and put it on top of this shop press frame. So hang on there. Let's have some fun.
Okay, Nick Collier here, and I think today we're actually going to put this thing in position over by the welding table so that if we need to do any welding, we don't have to drag the welder back and forth. And but the problem is, it took two people to get it in here, and now I'm by myself, and I can't really move it. So we're gonna use the crane I put in a year and a half ago, and we're gonna slide this thing over. Problem is that it's too tall. And too tall meaning that I'll lift it up with the crane and try to get it over the top of this table. I don't think it's gonna fit. So we're gonna have to drop this thing over on its side, grab it from the side, lift it up, and then drag it across the room. So hang in there. We're gonna play with this. Oh yeah, I forgot to say, this is gonna be one of those projects where, you know, maybe I'm gonna put this up on YouTube, next July or something like that, because it could take that long to get this thing, you know, up and running the way I want it to run. But who knows? Could be next week too. So right now it's November of 2015. Okay, let's have some fun. we got her in place, and now we just kind of start in. We're going to go down and get the hydraulic wood splitter and bring it up here and start stripping it out and transferring the hydraulic systems over to this. So hang in here. Who knows? It might be tomorrow I might be working on this, or it could be next week sometime, or it could be next year. See you then.
Okay, well, the first thing we got to do here, and maybe it's not the first thing, but it's what we can do right now, is, well, you don't see this, but this thing slides real nice and easy because I went in and cleaned up this whole shaft because it was totally rusted out. Now I'm coming up to the next rung. Oh, and that one fits okay. But come up to the next rung, and it's too tight because it has too much rust. So we're going to, and I'm looking around. I'm thinking, well, you know, what can I use to clean the rust out? And I'm going to back you up a little bit. And, I have a whole set of adjustable reamers, and for some reason, I don't have that exact 1-inch size. So I'm digging around, and what do I come up with is a 1-inch reamer. And, you know, I probably had this thing laying around for who knows how many years. Probably got it at a garage sale for, you know, a couple of bucks, and it fits perfect. And it's a cakewalk to do this. So we just kind of run it in by hand. Clean out the rust and the, actually it looks like there's some, the hole wasn't quite perfectly round. Probably before it was rusty, it was no big deal. But now that it's rusty, it's a whole different ball game. So let's throw a little oil on that. Okay, I gotta get a couple of tools out of the way here. Now that it's through, it'll pop right through to the next hole and ream that hole out without a problem. Whoa! That sucker is a squeaker. Man. All right, we made it through. Now let's see how our shaft will fit. Like a dream. You know, this ain't no Harbor Freight piece of crap either, too. You know, let's spin it over to the Harbor Freight. You know, I say this about Harbor Freight, but, you know, I buy the Harbor Freight tools. We're going to spin this around to the Harbor Freight one. And, it's a good press. But watch. Lift this thing up. That thing's got, a quarter inch of slop. This thing rocks back and forth. It does the job, but it doesn't do it as accurately as I'd like. And we're going to swing around to this one here. And we're going to look at the slop there. None. No slop. I like that. So, put this back down. We're going to run our reamer through here. And I think that's going to work. Yep, that one's fine. How about this one? Ooh, no. Okay, so I put a bit of a chamfer on that outer edge so that if it ever gets beat on again, it won't mushroom out. And now we're just basically coming in and sanding the surface, get the rust off. All right, keep your fingers crossed. but I think it's going to be okay. Oh, look at that. It's not okay. That side slides in. There must be a lip on this side here. Now it slides beautifully, but there must be something on here that's not allowing that. So we'll take it back, and I think I'm just going to file it down rather than, you know, try to machine it down, because we try to machine, you end up with it being just a little bit off. So we're going to go over and file it. All right, well, I got this big old bastard file, and it's very coarse, so I think it's going to take it down just... See how that does. All right, let's give it a try. Snug still. That's interesting. That side good, no problem. All right, well, let's take it down a little further. We'll be back. All right, well, there must have been some little rough edge on there or something, because now it fits just fine. Both directions. So we still have to ream out this one bottom hole, and we're all set as far as this is concerned.
Okay, Nick Collier here, and we're going to start tearing this thing apart. I still don't know if we're going to use this ram or not, but here's the whole setup. Why not? It's not quite as strong as I want it to be. But I think I'm going to be all right. So we're just going to kind of chew this thing apart, see what we've got. Okay, so now that we made a gigantic mess over there with about 2 gallons of hydraulic fluid, we're going to bring this ram over here and see how it's going to fit in between here and see if it's going to even work at all. So we still got to come up just a little bit. And we are looking for a plug. Here it is. Quite high enough, but I think we can get it. I mean, it's almost high enough. Looks like about what we're looking for. Now, of course, we got to take this big clevis off, which, you know, that's going to be a whole nother battle. I think I'm going to have to come in and put this on the mill and mill a couple of flats into here so I can grab it with a wrench and wrench that thing off. But for now, we're just looking to see how this could play out. And it looks like it could do pretty well, actually. I'm very pleased with that. We got oil everywhere. So that's about as high as we want. I'm thinking maybe even like something like this. I got a 24-inch throw here, so that's a good distance. Let's measure that and see. There's 24 inches right there. So, you know, there's plenty of room. Of course, we don't want to go all the way out to the extent. So maybe just down just a little bit. Something like that. So there's 24 inches right there. Okay, that should do the trick. Now, I don't know if you can see it, we need to go up in that direction, come in a little bit closer, and we're going to kind of just rough out what we need up here. And what I'm seeing is a pretty good honking piece of angle iron like this stuff going straight up on both sides, and then a pin going across to hold that thing in place. And then something like right in here to keep it from going back and forth, but still allowing it to be loose so that I can take it out when I need to and put it back on the wood splitter. So that's gonna be, I'd say, we've got 20 inches. Let's take it to 22 and then we're set. Well, I don't know. 18 is our real number, so 20 would give us just about right. Yep, I'd say so. Yeah, good start. So we're going to go out and dig around and see if we can come up with a couple of pieces of angle iron that heavy. Well, it doesn't have to be exactly that heavy because, you know, we're going to be going vertically. So it's going to be in compression, or actually not compression, expansion. But still, we're not pulling on the weight of the angle itself or the channel itself. So, we're going to go out and see what I can dig up. Okay, I found some pretty heavy angle. It's not quite as heavy as that piece as the pieces on that, but still good and stout anyhow. And this came off of an old trailer that I had in this space some 10 or 15 years ago. I've used little pieces here and there, but now I'm going to use a fairly substantial chunk. Let's see what we've got. There we go.
take that down and
I like to put this piece in here, and that way when the piece falls, it just kind of drops about a couple inches, and it doesn't make a whole bunch of noise and bang up things.
Yeah, we're just going to let that cut for a while. Okay, so now, because there's going to be a lot of pressure going up, and this is, what is this, maybe 1/4 inch, it might even be thinner than that, I think what I want to do is just beef this up a little bit along here. So I've come up with this piece of, what is that, 1/2 inch, maybe 3/4 inch by 3 inches. This piece of steel... my buddy called me up one day and said he was weed eating in his backyard. You know, we live up here in the gold country, where all of these buildings were built in the 1800s and stuff. And he said he ran across this piece of steel. Would I want it? Of course, I went over there and grabbed it. This thing was probably, it was almost 20 feet long. And it was kind of torqued and warped from age, and it was just rusty as hell. It must have been laying there for 100 years. And so I grabbed it. And over the years, I've, chewed off 6 inches here, a foot there. And I'm down to about 6 feet now. And it looks like I'm going to take another 6 inches per cut. And I'm going to do 2 cuts. So we'll do that. This will drop right down in here, and then we're going to drill a hole through the whole thing, and that way we'll have our pin will go through some substantial steel. All right, well, this being a piece of channel from an old trailer that I had on the property, it has a layer, and a thick layer of tar on all of the metal, including this channel. So, I've fought with this over the years and never was really successful too much with anything until just a few minutes ago, and I thought, well, wait a second. Tar is, petroleum products, and paint is petroleum products. Why am I not using paint stripper? And sure enough, works like a dream. Look at that. Taking it right there. Okay, so we want to come in and clean this metal up so that so the weld can take real well. And also at the same time, I want to heat the metal up. And what better way to do it than to grind on it a little bit. All right, put our clamp on. Oops, wait a second. Well, we can roll it. Let's put it over on one side first. Get it down just a little further. That looks pretty good. Okay, so, and we're going to stick weld this because, you know, I just know that stick weld is so much more beefy. It holds things together so much better. And so that's what's going to happen here. All right, let's weld. I'm seeing that there's a pretty good size gap between the red clevis there and my supports. And my fear is as I put the pin in, put a little pressure on that, and that pin will bend because it's not a shear. And then I'll never get it out. So what I have to do is I have to come in and put something in between this, and I'm going to come in close as I'm dealing with one hand here. Let's see if we can do that. From here to the face of the clevis itself. And so we're going to take some measurements and figure something out. We'll be back. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to come in with a piece of round something and add a 1 inch, 1¾ inch to this, and have it so that it'll miss this plate here, but it'll still have an area where we can drill through. So we'll drill through this and the piece of round stock, and then drill through the other side too, of course, and then our pin will be able to go through, and it'll sit nice and flush with this here, and then we have a shear on the pin rather than a kind of stretched out and bending it. So we're gonna take this thing apart and go from there. Well, I don't know. I think my blade's getting a little dull. What do you think? That wasn't exactly a straight cut, now was it? But it was a cut, and all we have to do is go in and machine it. Throw it on the lathe and straighten it out a bit. And that'll be good enough. All right,
okay,
let's
straighten out some lines here because, man, that thing is in bad shape.
we're set there. Turn our fan off. Not too bad. And they're about the same size. Doesn't really matter because they're going to be positioned forward and backward and then welded in place. So, you know, we can be within 40 or 50 thousandths without a problem. Okay, so we've got our block of steel, or our round of steel, and we're going to come in and weld this to our frame. And, okay, we'll heat it up just a little bit, just to get a decent weld in there. Because it's pretty cold in here. Okay, so we've let them cool off some, and they're just nice and warm at this point. I've set it up on the bridge port. We're going to come in, we're going to drill a hole down the center of that, and then we're going to measure from that hole out to the edge here and square up this edge, because my saw, the blade is not real new, and it didn't exactly cut perfect. So we want to get a nice square edge there, and a perfect hole there, and a good distance. So what we're gonna do is measure this, and I believe it's 6 inches. 6 inches, so we'll come back to 3. Boy, that doesn't seem like center now, does it? Oh, no, it's 3 plus the half inch. What is this? Let's make sure it's half inch. It's not. What do we got here? Yeah, half inch. So 3 500. I must have did 2 500, so we're going to go 3 500 right to there. That looks a little better. And then 300 and 500 back from here, just to confirm it. And we're sitting right there. Let me put a little dye on here. Well, actually, it's too warm for the pen. All right, so we're going to start by drilling our hole here. And I put a tap follower in, and I've set up my center. And we're just going to kind of drop down. I need my cheater glasses. We're going to drop right down onto that center point. Right there and there. And maybe back just a little bit. And back this way just a little bit. Lock everybody in place. Start it with a center drill.